I can say that YouTube literally saved me from depression, from leaving my husband, and best of all, it gave me a community of people that really care for me. You guys. Hi everyone, I'm Nomfundo, and I've decided to share this video with you guys because I've had some interesting and some borderline horrible comments in comment section of some of my videos. Therefore, I decided to make this video to clarify comments like this one right here. Yep. Someone commenting about my interracial relationship with my husband, Tim. So let's rewind a bit to get to how all of this happened. So if you are new here, my name is Nomfundo. I'm a South African living in Switzerland with my German husband. Well, how did I get here? Let's go back to my time in South Africa. Before I moved to Switzerland, I was a boss babe. You know, I was living my best life. I was traveling the world. I had a good job. You know, everything was going well. I just bought my second property. I just bought my dream car. And everything was just perfect. The only thing that was missing was obviously my dream man, Tim, who then I met in 2022 when he came to South Africa for a job that he had. Fast forward to 2023. Actually, doesn't seem like a fast forward thing that's needed there because it's literally a couple of months later, we decided to get married. Actually, we got married a year later, but a couple of months before that, we decided to get married. So I came to Switzerland in March of 2023. I came to visit Tim, and then in May of 2023, we got married. So that is how I ended up living in Switzerland because I got married and then I moved to Switzerland permanently. Well, as permanent can be. You know, the world is a big place. Anyways, we're not talking about that right now. So after getting married in May, I was able to apply for my B permit that allows me to legally stay in Switzerland as a person, as a resident, right? And you guys saw that video as well, I showed you guys. So in the meantime, while I was waiting for my permit to come out, my visa expired, the one that I was on here, because it was only for 3 months. So when it expired, it meant that I am not able to leave the Schengen zone. If I do leave, I will need to apply for another visa. So this meant I can travel in the Schengen area, but I cannot, for example, go to South Africa and be with my family, you know, like visit my family or, you know, go somewhere else outside of the Schengen zone. So in that time, bear in mind where we live, it's a very tiny village. They only speak French. I'm the only black person here. There's like 300 of us that live in this village. That's how tiny it is. We don't even have our own supermarket. That's how tiny it is. So I find myself living in this place. And if you guys already have seen our other videos, there's this one specific video that I shared about how our life is because Tim travels for work. So most of the time, I'm not even most of the time, 99.99% of the time, I am by myself unless Tim is on vacation and he takes vacation and then we can be together. But most of the time, he's not in the country. So now I find myself living in this place. I do not speak the language. I do not have any friends. I am not working because I cannot work. I don't have a permit, a right to work. You know, so I find myself sitting here and every day it's the same thing. I wake up, I eat, I sleep. I don't talk to other people. The only people I talk to are my family, my friends on the phone, like video calls, phone calls, WhatsApp, text. I engage on social media content, like, you know, things like that. But I don't have like physical friends and, you know, that social circle that meets physically for me to be able to be like, oh, okay, I've got plans and I'm going out. I try to go out by myself. I go for walks, but I'm still by myself. So that actually started affecting me a lot. Like I used to have days where I didn't want to wake up. I literally just wouldn't even open the blinds in the apartment. I would just sit in the dark. I was questioning a lot. Like, was this the right decision? Like moving here. Obviously, I loved him and everything. But I started questioning and being like, he's never home. What difference does it make where I am in the world if I'm working? And, you know, and this comes from the fact that I've been that person who's been self-sustaining all this time. I take care of myself. I, you know, I've been doing me the whole time. And now I find myself in a situation where I can't even work. So that was very difficult for me. I was in a dark place. There were times when I told Tim, I just want to go home, you know, because I was feeling like it's not worth it. I am drowning in. So I think I was like on the verge of getting depressed. I won't say I was actually depressed, but I was just not feeling myself. I was very down. I was snappy towards Tim. I found myself crying, you know, for no reason. I'd just be horrible to him. And I felt bad for not just myself, but for him as well, because I'm like, this poor man is bearing the brunt of how I am feeling. And I wanted to communicate to him, but then it wasn't coming out the right way, if I may put it like that. But it was a very dark place. And I think it was all because, like I mentioned, I just wanted to work. And I cannot work because I don't have the permit, right, to work. And even at this time, during the time that I'm waiting, I was like, okay, let me apply, you know, for work. I can always say my permit is coming out. I can show all of that. So I was applying. I had like great opportunities. I had, sometimes they would be like, oh, okay, we'd like to have you, but where's your permit? And then I'd be like, oh, I'm waiting. And they're like, oh, unfortunately, you need to have a permit. And I could understand because, you know, what if the permit is rejected, or what if I get a permit and it's the permit, because apparently here in Switzerland, you can get, well, I think in most places as well, but I've heard that yes, you can get a B permit, but it might say you cannot work. So there's two types of permits, you know, for the B permit, the one that allows you to work and the one that does not allow you to work. So I completely understood the companies that would be like, we really need to see your permit. Great. So that was also getting to me. And then the other thing as well was, sometimes I would get so many rejections. Guys, I've never had so many rejections in my life. Like, yo, guys, it's worse than being dumped. It's worse than umjolo going down the drain. Hi guys, rejections when you're looking for a job. It can crush your soul. It makes you feel inadequate. So I was feeling all of these things. I was feeling like I was just in this dark hole. And mainly this was because I was alone most of the time and I was not working. I was not doing anything, you know, during the day. All I did was wake up, eat, sleep, wake up, eat, sleep, go for a walk. Like Tim would call me and he'd be like, babe, you go for a walk, you know, you feel better. Just go outside, fresh air. And I'd be like, yo, guys, I am over this fresh air thing. I am over just going outside for a walk. I was just drowning in this black hole that was just pulling me further and further in. Fast forward to me getting my permit. Great. I'm thinking things are going to turn around. I'm going to get a job within, like, you know, babe and I were confident. We were like, now I've got the permit. I'm going to get it like this. But the permit came out in October. Guys, if I tell you that even with the permit, it's been difficult. You apply either the language. Like, I was even rejected Guma supermarkets, guys. Like, if South African, you know, ShopRite, Pick and Pay, Checkers. Me, a whole person that did a PhD. Hey, sana. Anyways, we are not even there. I'm not gonna say that, you know, because of my education I need to be given preference or anything, but I'm just saying that a supermarket would say no. But I also understand it's the language, because if I'm going to be working in a supermarket here or at a McDonald's and I don't speak the language, it's like, who am I serving? Because if someone comes to me and asks me something, I'm like, oh, sorry, I can't speak French. But also the other thing is, even in the application, it's not like I'm saying I do not speak the language, but automatically I just wouldn't get, which is fine, you know. But it wasn't fine at that time. Now I'm okay with everything, because in November, late November, December, it's 9:30, guys. It rings once every half an hour. So it's 9:30 p.m. now. So in December, a friend of mine, very close friend of mine, brought me back to God, if I may put it like that. She brought me back. She gave me that hope again through the word of God, which I'm forever grateful for, guys. Her name is Gadgadian. Go check her out. She's a gut health coach. But yeah. So guys, then with that, I was really drowning because I was not doing anything. I was feeling very useless. You know, I felt like Babe works so hard. Guys, he works so hard and I'm doing nothing in return. And that's not me. You know, I've been working all my life, not all my life, but I mean like my adulthood, I've been working and I've been making money. And now that I have someone that I love and I would love to spoil, I would love to, you know, do all of these things, I cannot do that. Yo, I wasn't okay. I was like, let me go home. I was ready to leave because I was like, I'm going to get depressed if I stay here. So I'd rather go home, go work at back home, make money. Because anyways, I felt like Babe is never home either. So we can see each other when he's free or when I can, you know, because at the end of the day, yeah. But then I realized as well that going home and coming back here, it's not going to change anything. I'm going to come back. I'm going to still need to start looking for work. And it's just, yeah, let me just rather stay and work on myself. So this is how I then decided, hey, I like making videos. I've been filming myself from I don't know how long, since I was doing undergraduate. No, not let me not lie. I've been filming myself since I started traveling outside of South Africa. And I like taking videos. Like, I really do. If you can see, like, my first video, some of them were even in portrait, because I was not taking videos thinking I'm going to post on YouTube. Even my videos that I have mostly were not videos that I thought, oh, I'm going to post on YouTube, because these were just videos that I take of my travels, of my day, because I just like taking videos. I think I like talking to the camera. I think I like talking to the camera too much, but I've just enjoyed taking videos. And I was like, hey, you know, I'm sitting at home. I've got all of these videos that are sitting. Let me edit the videos. And that's how I found myself editing videos and putting them up on YouTube. And this, for me, was a way of keeping myself busy, a way of taking my mind off the fact that I am isolated in this place. I don't have friends around here. You know, I don't speak the language, so I cannot get a community. You know, all of these things, it helped me get me out. It pulled me out of that hole, because I started filling my time with editing YouTube videos. I know in the beginning, it was literally just like me putting a video together, posting it, you know, not even thinking about YouTube as a thing of, yeah, you know, like, oh, okay, I want to be a professional YouTuber. But it was just a way of keeping myself busy, posting on YouTube and just sharing, you know, like my travels, like, and then my life of, you know, every day, what we're doing, what we get up to and all of that. And that is how YouTube, like I'm saying, literally saved me from getting depressed, because at that brink when I was almost sinking, I started editing videos and posting on YouTube, and that gave me that sense of I'm doing something and I have something to do during my time, during the day, and therefore I'm no longer in that dark space where I feel useless and I'm not doing anything. I know I'm not bringing money with YouTube, but still, it gives me something to do during the day. It gives me something to do when I'm by myself. So instead of waking up, eating, sleeping, you know, and thinking, I am now waking up, I check my emails, I check my comments on YouTube, I talk to people. Like I said, like, it gave me a community. I feel like I have met a great bunch of people that genuinely care for me. Like, I remember the first time I didn't post in a while and someone was like, hi Bo, girl, where's the video? And I felt like, oh my word, there's people that actually, you know, would like me to post a video, that see my videos and actually want to see more that's happening. I had a comment where someone was like, now you're giving us gappy videos where we don't know what happened before this. The last one was this, and now all of a sudden it's here. And I'm like, oh my word, you know, that made me feel like I've got a community of people that actually care for, like, and I feel like you guys are now like family and friends because you get to see our life. I'm sharing our life. And if you notice, if I go back to that comment, right, that person was talking about, oh, how, why us African women, once we date or are now married to a white guy, we start posting on YouTube. If you can even notice, my content is not centered around our relationship. My content is centered around our travels, my day. I have videos where I'm just by myself at home and I'm showing you the village, you know. And even in the videos, Tim does not talk a lot in the videos. You guys can hear him in the background. You guys can hear me talking to him. He comes, yes, he shows his face once and says, hi guys. And he's not even in the video. So my content is not because of I'm married to a white guy and now I'm posting on YouTube. No. My content, the reason why I started on YouTube is because I needed something to help me get out of that black hole that I was getting into. And which also actually, in turn, I believe saved our relationship because I again started being myself, you know, the girl, the woman that Tim fell in love with, because I was starting to be a very horrible person, honestly speaking. And it hurt me that I was being horrible to the one person that truly loves me and is taking care of me, regardless of my situation, you know, and me thinking of leaving and going back to South Africa. There was a point where I was like, guys, I can always, you know, go back home. I can go somewhere else in the world where they want me, because I felt like Switzerland does not want me. So all of that is my reason why I started YouTube, and how YouTube has changed my life, how YouTube has saved me from this dark hole that I was finding myself in. And interesting enough, yesterday, as in yesterday, this video is the most recent one because it's happening in real time. This is me in real time. There was another comment that said, girl, when was this happening? I feel like, can you just fast forward to where you are now? This is where I am now. This is like a day after I got accepted into the, well, I qualified to be a partner, a YouTube partner, which is amazing. I'm waiting for them to, they review my channel now. And it's all because of you guys. You know, I never thought of this. Yes, I've loved YouTube. I've known YouTube for a while. And I never thought that I would be a part of the YouTube Partner Program because I was just posting, you know, content because I'm like, oh, you know, I am doing this because I love taking videos. And now let me share my travels with whoever's going to watch. And I never thought that now I could be at 1,880 people that are like saying, okay, we subscribed. And most of you come back and you watch again. That really makes me happy because, like I mentioned, you guys have become my community of people that I feel like I see every day when I post my videos, because you guys see the video and then you guys comment, you like, you share. And thank you for that as well, because if it wasn't for you, I wouldn't be here. I feel like I wouldn't be able to say I'm happy again. I am, you know, I'm where I am because of you guys. So thank you so much for that. And this is to say, you know, if you find yourself in a situation, it doesn't matter what kind of situation it is, as a person, do something, you know, try to help yourself, be it unemployment, be it in a broken relationship or a relationship that has ended, be it school, be it whatever it is. Try to find something that will give you hope. Try to find something that will get you out of that place, you know? Because really, I feel like we are responsible for our happiness as an individual, as a person. God has given that to us. You know, He has given us a choice in everything. We choose to be happy, to be depressed, to be happy, to be sad, you know? We choose to love and not to love. We choose all of these things. There was this saying that I was doing, reading a devotional this morning, and it resonated so much with this video because they said that you need to make the most of the situation that you are in right now. Even if it is not the situation you want to be in, even if the situation is horrible, find a way to make it work for you. find a way to make that situation work for you, the best for you, which is what I have found through making YouTube videos. So guys, that is how YouTube has changed my life. That is how YouTube literally, I feel like it has saved my life, saved my relationship because of that. Those are my reasons. That is what I was going through. That is how I got here. So do share in the comment if you got this far. Do share in the comment why you think I started YouTube. Do you also think like that person that I started the channel because I'm married to a white man? Why do you think I started? Don't forget to like, to subscribe, and to share this video. As my flesh died, so I had to come say thank you guys so much. Hope you enjoy the rest of your day, and I will see you guys in the next video. Bye. I'm gonna have a shot now, shot of masala from our favorite place, Alpha. Cheers.